After that, Surah Al-Shams, the sun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with saying, وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by the sun and its brightness. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا, by the moon as it follows it. You notice, sisters, sometimes Allah mentions the day, then the night. And sometimes the night, then the day. So this is, he is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the creator, to start with the sun or to start with the moon, to start with the day, to start with the night. All of them creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are great. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making the oath by these great things, his creation subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا, by the day as it shows up the sun's brightness. Okay, during the day you see the sun and the brightness of the sun. This is ni'mah. This is no doubt a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the countries, you know, sometimes it is a cloudy day, 2 days, 3 days. Subhanallah, you feel depressed because you cannot see the sun and the brightness of the sun. So this is ni'mah when you see the sun. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَخْشَاهَا, by the night as it conceals it. Subhanallah, you feel at night the sunset and the sunlight disappears gradually. Okay, you feel that as if the night is covering the day. Okay, يَخْشَاهَا, to cover it. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَخْشَاهَا وَالسَّمَاءَ وَمَا بَنَاهَا, by the heaven and him who built it. Subhanallah. Who built the heaven? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without pillars, as we mentioned before. وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا, by the earth and him who spread it. Okay, as we mentioned many times, you drive your car maybe 5, 6, 10 hours, no mountains. Yes, there are mountains. Okay, but you can drive your car for hours without mountains, straight path. Who made the ground flat like that? It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, وَنَفْس وَمَا سَوَّاهَا, by nafs. Okay, the nafs, soul, and him who perfected him in proportion. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this nafs, yani perfect. Yani it is not, you know, we can notice that by what we are making. I mean, as human beings, the cars, computers, the things, they are not perfect. Subhanallah. The creation of Allah is perfect. I mean, look at your heart. It's beating 24 hours without rest. Your blood circulating in your vessels. Okay, 24 hours, how many liters of blood are running in your vessels? Big vessels, medium, small. So Allah made this perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Verse number 8, then he showed him what is wrong for him and what is right for him, like the previous ayah. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ, the straight path is right, is clear. The right path is clear to paradise. And also the bad path is clear. So Allah made the things clear for you. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned, Al-halalu bayyin, wal-haramu bayyin. Halal, lawful things are clear. And haram things are clear. وَبَيْنَاهُمَ أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ. And between them there are doubtful issues. لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنَّ النَّاسِ. Most of people or many people don't know them. But the scholars, they know. رحمهم الله تعالى. Then he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Indeed, he succeeds who purifies his own self. How? By obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you obey Allah, it means you are purifying yourself. You are purifying your soul. Okay? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. Then you succeed. Okay? You are a winner if you purify yourself by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَدْ خَاب مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. And indeed he fails who corrupts his own self. How? By disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. those who disobey Allah, they are the losers. Okay, there is a problem with the voice, sisters. Someone is saying this is breaking. Okay, طيب. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا, and indeed he fails who corrupts his own selves. So, sisters, if you notice, this concept is repeated many times in the Quran and also in the Sunnah. You can save yourself and you can spoil yourself and destroy and damage yourself. You choose. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the choice. It is our option to choose this path or the other path. It is your choice, sisters, to put the hijab or to remove the hijab, to put the niqab or to remove the niqab, to pray or not to pray. No one is forcing you. Don't claim that Allah chose me to be a kafir, Allah chose me to be a Muslim, Allah chose me to be a practicing Muslim or not. Yes, everything under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah gave you the choice subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have, sisters, we have to follow the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you are not practicing Islam, from now you should practice Islam. If you are not practicing the hijab, please, sister, practice the hijab. This is very important. This is fard from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't listen to those, okay, who claim the hijab is not fard, astaghfirullah al-azim. So, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an example of the second group, those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people of the Prophet Salih, Thamud. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, Thamud, people of Salih, denied their prophet through their transgression by rejecting the true faith of Islamic monotheism, Tawheed. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا. Okay, they committed the sins, and the major sin, the worst sin that they committed is to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا. عَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ. Then he said, إِذِنْ بَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا. Allah did not mention the whole story here, but he mentioned here part of it, إِذِنْ بَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا. Okay, but the messenger of Allah, عليه السلام, said to them, when the most wicked man among them went forth, which means to kill the she-camel, Naqa. What was one of the miracles of Salih is the she-camel. So one of them decided to kill them, to kill the she-camel. Not alone, he did not decide alone. They agreed, but he went there to kill. And the scholars mention his name is Qudar ibn Salif. His name is Qudar ibn Salif. He is the worst man. إِذِنْ بَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا فَقَالَ لَهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ نَاقَةَ اللَّهِ وَسُقْيَاهَا. طيب, the messenger of Allah, Salih, which means Salih alayhi salatu wasalam. But the messenger of Allah said to them, that is the she camel of Allah. Don't harm it and bar it not from having its drink. Subhanallah. Because what was the deal between Salih alayhi salatu wasalam and his people? لَهَا شِرْبْ وَلَكُمْ شِرْبْ يَوْمْ مَعْلُومٌ. Okay, there was water. So what was the deal? That Salih told them, one day the camel has the right to drink from this water, and it is not allowed for you to approach this water. The other day, you are allowed to drink from the water. And the scholars mention when it is the day of the camel to drink from the water, then it is allowed for you to take the milk of this camel, of this she camel. But subhanallah, they did not respect the Prophet Salih alayhi salatu wasalam, and they killed the camel, and they disobeyed Allah, and they disbelieved in Salih and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها. Then they denied him, they disbelieved in Salih, they disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they killed it. So their Lord destroyed them. because of their sin and made them equal in destruction. فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها. Allah destroyed all of them. Allah punished all of them the same way. طيب, then he said سبحانه وتعالى, the last ayah, ولا يخاف عقباها. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى doesn't fear the consequences thereof. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the great, العظيم. He is not like us. Yeah, for example, even if I am a strong man, I have an army, then I go to another country, another people, another group, I kill them or I punish them, I attack them. Still, I have a kind of fear. Maybe they fight me again, they come to me with other countries. So I have a kind of fear. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no. Allah doesn't fear anyone, anything. ولا يخاف عقبا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't fear the consequences subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he did subhanahu wa ta'ala. He destroyed them and they did nothing because khalas, now they are.